On today's episode, electric car demand is through the roof. But where will the lithium come from? Today's episode is brought to you by engineering.com, a globally trusted source for engineering content. Check out this and many other exclusive videos for the engineering professional found only on engineering.com TV today. No change in fundamental technology has ever been so widely predicted and legislatively driven as has been the shift from the internal combustion engine to electric drive. Every major automotive manufacturer on the planet is either producing electric vehicles or rapidly tooling up to do so, and several jurisdictions have taken active measures to ensure that consumers buy the product. Recent US legislation includes considerable incentives for purchasers of EVs and incentives for firms to build them. And the phenomenon is worldwide. One Australian bank has gone so far as to stop providing new car loans for fossil fuel cars starting in 2025. Now, several nations have proposed the prohibition of sales of gasoline and diesel vehicles in the 2030 to 2035 timeframe as well. That's a rapid transition, about half the average life expectancy of a modern internal combustion engine vehicle, and the automotive industry will be hard-pressed to deliver the necessary number of vehicles. Currently, the critical choke point is the supply of batteries, and the key input to battery production is the lithium used for the cells. According to the U.S. Geological Survey, in 2018, 85,000 tons of lithium were produced worldwide from a 14 million ton known reserve, with 56% of the metal used for batteries. Among traditional automakers, Volkswagen leads the transition, in no small part due to the diesel emissions scandal of 2015, in the aftermath of which, VW has agreed to spend $2 billion in brand neutral, zero emission vehicle infrastructure programs, primarily charging stations. For companies like VW making the transition, securing the lithium needed to feed the battery supply chain is crucial. Look at this VW map describing their new versus old procurement strategy. South America, Africa, and Australia will likely be big winners in the new lithium-driven resource rush. Even with accelerated resource development, it's unclear if lithium production can keep pace with demand. According to the International Energy Agency, just under 10% of global car sales were electric in 2021, four times the market share of 2019. First quarter sales in 2022 are up 75% from the same period in 2021, and this spike in demand has had a heavy impact on commodities pricing. By May of this year, lithium prices were seven times higher than the beginning of 2021. While large reserves of the metal are located in Australia, Chile, and the Congo, over half of lithium processing and refining capacity is located in China. The numbers are stark. According to the IEA, 60% of new vehicle sales in 2030 will be electric. But even if electric vehicle sales are only half that number, 30%, the demand for lithium will increase globally by six times by 2030. New battery technology promises to reduce the need for other critical materials such as nickel and cobalt, but lithium remains the weakest link in the chain. For automakers, the global war for lithium now requires end users of the raw material to choose long-term supply contracts, both to feed joint venture battery-making operations and to backstop production rates for their Tier 1 suppliers. Not since Henry Ford invested in iron ore and latex production to feed his assembly lines a century ago have automotive OEMs been forced all the way up to the source of the supply chain. Batteries are the determining factor in electric vehicle pricing, and with economies of scale, battery prices have been falling, dropping 6% per kilowatt hour in 2021 compared to 2020, but that decline is slowing. According to the IEA, if lithium prices in 2022 remain as high as they were in the first quarter, battery packs will be 15% more expensive than they were last year, all else being equal. Electric vehicles will become more expensive. Can consumers afford them even if they're motivated to buy? Well, government incentives will shield auto buyers from factors like high lithium prices in the short term, but only more metal, very quickly, will deliver cost parity with the internal combustion engines by the end of the decade. Well, that's it for today's episode of This Week in Engineering, brought to you by engineering.com. For our deeper engineering series, visit engineering.com TV for exclusive shows like Manufacturing the Future and Designing the Future, not found on our YouTube channel. The links are in the description below. Thanks for watching.